Once again, the coward police of Uvalde proven that they were not capable of saving those children. A mother stood up, a mother was arrested trying to save her children. She was handcuffed. She got out of the handcuffs, ran into the school and saved both of her children and other children as well. Put up the picture of this amazing woman. Look at that. It has been just over a month since the community of Uvalde experienced the tragedy of a gunman who killed 19 children and two teachers at Robb Elementary. There's a mother, you're looking at her. She took matters into her own hands when she heard gunshots while outside of the elementary school. Put up another picture of this mother, all right? She doesn't have any combat gear. She had no weapons training, nor did she have a weapon. She had no tactical background. She had no backup. As a matter of fact, when she tried to initially save her own children, the police arrested her. Her name is Angeli Rose Gomez. She says she heard there was an active shooter and quickly rushed to the school where her two young boys went. It was just moments when she walked up to the school and was face to face with law enforcement when she heard gunshots, then children screaming inside. Ms. Gomez said law enforcement were not doing what she hoped. So she tried to get some parents to force some action to get law enforcement into the school. And you know the rest of the story. Law enforcement decided to wait on magical keys and backup they already had and gear that was already on their body. All right, there's more. Ms. Gomez said authorities were telling her if she did not cooperate with them, that she would be handcuffed. She eventually was. They arrested this woman. Now they're targeting her after she saves children. She then told them she would cooperate and calm down. She lied. She lied to the police, and rightfully so. She says, I will calm down. Please make sure you take these handcuffs off of me. They did so. As soon as they, being the police, take me off the cuff, I see his arm like, give me a little gateway because I'm real little. So a little gateway where I can just run. She was looking for an opportunity to save a life, to save the lives of her children. There's more. Gomez says there was no doubt in her mind. She would run into the school and save her children herself, which is what she planned to do. Immediately, Ms. Gomez jumped a fence and began banging on a door window where she saw her oldest son's teacher. Ms. Gomez told her, like, you already have a gateway out, so might as well just come out like I'm going to run out with them. Y'all just come on too. Within minutes, Ms. Gomez was able to get her oldest son and some of his classmates out, but her youngest was still inside. She ran around the school desperately searching for his classroom. She's going to save the second baby. She tells them to evacuate the school or she won't leave her spot. Immediately, they started evacuating the classroom. And my son runs out to me and he's like, mom, mom. I just remember when my son saw my other son, one hugged the other. One said, I'm so glad you're okay. And the other one said, I was so worried you were not. Ever since that day, Ms. Gomez says, the police have been at her home. The other night we were exercising and we had a cop parked at the corner like flickering us with his headlights. Because of these incidents, Ms. Gomez said she has had to separate her boys just so my sons don't feel like they have to watch cops passing by, stopping, parking. All right, let's get it, okay? What's happening here? Bottom line, you have a mother who did what the cops did not do. This mother saved the lives not only of her children, but also of others. The police tried to stop her. She had no gun. She had no weapons training. She's just a mother. She had the right idea. Remember the other police officer who got a call from his wife who was dying? He tried to get into the school to save his wife, possibly save children. He gets arrested, basically disarmed and taken off the property. What about the parents who tried to pressure law enforcement to let them in. They were threatened with arrest themselves. What in the hell is going on? Why are the leaders of that police department still being paid? Why is the commander still on the payroll? Why are the cops still employed? What other government agency could have this kind of disaster that led to the direct deaths of children? And that government agency would still protect the workers inside of it. Would this happen with watershed management or maybe the communications department at a local municipality? There's no such thing. You do something this egregious, there's real world impact, you gotta go. But not the police, all of a sudden there's a different conversation. Attorney, what are your thoughts on this case?
I think that this is just as despicable as Uvalde Police Department and the school district police department. The fact is we've gotten lies out of lies about what they did not do in terms of saving those children. And the reality is that this mother, Ms. Gomez, did save her children and many more by virtue of the fact that she did what they couldn't and wouldn't do because they lacked the courage. The thing that gets me most is there was also a part where she was being threatened with a possibility of a probation violation as well. She received a phone call from law enforcement and she ended up going before a judge and the judge said what you did was courageous and we will not be revoking your probation at all. And so law enforcement has been trying every tactic under the sun to threaten her, to make her feel small, little, and to keep her from speaking with the media and just to punish her for saving her children. And it's not only not fair, it is illegal as far as I'm concerned. And there needs to be charges pressed. But unfortunately, as we still see these people remain in their positions, it really shows us that the system, not only is it here not to protect us, but it is here to actively oppress us.
Very well said.